What's up, Moda Brats? It's Special God here, and I'm sorry for not uploading for over a month. Yeah, that's all. I'm sorry, but I'm again uploading all the videos. But today we're gonna do a new move on Art of Water, which is gonna be super awesome. Naruto is gonna be super OP, and yeah, this what is called What if Naruto died and got reincarnated. So if you guys don't get the gist of it, you will get explained in the story. So yeah, without any further ado, let's get watching. So this story starts at the time of the Land of Waves. Yeah, we are going to start with the part one of the Naruto series, because I think this part would be a big difference. And yeah, so this starts after Haku got Raikiri through his heart, for saving Zabuza, and he died. And after seeing that Haku died, Naruto in the canon was like, oh no, and he started tearing up and all. But this time he got a huge heart attack. Okay guys, he got a huge heart attack. He clenched his fist and bow down and clenched his fist and started to breathe heavily. Kakashi, who saw this, thought that it was his first time seeing someone get killed, so that was the thing. So he just brushed it off. So Sakura didn't really care about him and was just crying over Sasuke. And Zabuza, was just there, doing stuff. And now Gato comes and Zabuza does the whole. But Naruto here is clenching his fist. Okay, after Zabuza die, after Zabuza kills, and Kakashi picks up Zabuza and keeps it near Haku, everyone senses, even Zabuza senses, a huge spike of chakra. And when they all turn around, they see Naruto basically with a red cloak covering his body. His chakra is huge. I mean huge, okay? The word huge doesn't even measure how much chakra Naruto is currently showing off right now. Sasuke, after sensing that much chakra, he just stood up like, what the hell is happening? He got on guard, and his one Tamoe Sharingan, one and two Tamoe Sharingan was, spinning, so he could see what the hell was happening. He saw Naruto, and the huge amount of chakra just scared the shit out of him. Kakashi, Sakura just got knocked out, and Tazuna Sakura just got knocked out. What's his name? Yeah, Sasuke fell to his knees and started shitting himself. Kakashi was just barely standing, and Zabuza died with the whole chakra blood pressure thing. And Naruto, shows up his head. His eyes has a slit, and he performs a set of hand signs which Kakashi can't really know. And Naruto whispers something which Kakashi can hear very well. Edo Tensei, impure world reincarnation. And this he says while stuttering, and then the chakra cloak which was surrounding him and the eye slit which was there, went off, and Naruto just fell to the ground and lifeless actually. Kakashi, quickly ran towards Naruto to check his breathing part, and he wasn't breathing. Kakashi, shook him several times, but Naruto wasn't breathing. Okay, his pulse, he even checked his pulse, and yeah, Naruto wasn't breathing. Kakashi was panicking right now. But before he could even think of anything else, a swirl of pattern surrounded Haku's body. Yes, Haku's body, and then it just flew up a little, and then a bright flash came up, and Sasuke was alive, awake on all this. He was seeing. This blind activated his second Tamoe Sharingan in his other eye, because the whole bloodlust thing already activated his second Tamoe, and now this thing, the whole blue thing, I mean the blur thing also activated his 3-term of Sharingan. It was just a graduate. He just activated his 1-term of Sharingan and it just grew into 3. Yeah. So after the light diminished, there was Naruto, but he was weird. It seemed like he has markings across his face, and when he slowly opened his eyes, Kakashi saw, and he was flabbergasted. Sasuke got knocked out because he couldn't handle the whole thing. Sasuke got knocked out, and just Kakashi was there seeing all of this. The bridge builders, well, they got knocked out because of the huge blood pressure, because they were a ninja. And yeah, Kakashi was the only one who could see this. His eye, when he opened his eyes were still blue, but his outer layer of his eyes were black. He slowly opened his eyes and looked at Kakashi, and he just shrugged his shoulders and said, "Well, Kakashi-sensei, we need to talk about what the hell happened." Kakashi he saw Naruto, then saw the dead body of Naruto he was having in his hand, then saw Naruto, then again saw the dead body. He was just confused. Naruto slowly walked up to the dead body of his original body. He took it, threw it up, and used a fire flamethrower jutsu to burn the body. Naruto was shocked. Naruto was not shocked. I mean, Kakashi was shocked. So basically, the thing over there burnt Naruto's body. Okay, Kakashi quickly reached for his kunai, but Naruto just raised his hand and said, "Calm down, Kakashi-sensei, I'm the real Naruto." Then Kakashi said, "How? How would you prove that?" Naruto just put his hand up in his chin and said, "Well, you come late for training practices. You always give excuse for, black cat got in my way. I was walking the path of life." And before he could say anything, Kakashi let his guard down, put his kunai back, and was like, "Yeah, you're Naruto, but what the hell was that?" Kakashi asked, and Naruto said, "Well, as I said, we need to talk, but I think I need to talk to you three, Sasuke, Sakura, and you." Kakashi, heard this and was kind of wanted to ask Naruto what the hell, he should just say it now, but Kakashi understood that he wanted to tell the other two as well, so he decided to wait his questions for a bit. Time skipped 3 days later. Now, 3 days have passed and Sasuke and Sakura woke up a day later. Sasuke quickly realized that he had the 3-term of Sharingan, which he was happy, but he was quite suspicious about why the hell Naruto's eyes were like that and why does he have this weird basically lines in his face and in his hands. He just really can't, it just seems that it's Naruto, but it's not Naruto at the same time. He just can't take off the feeling for some reason. But Naruto says that, he would explain everything. Sakura woke up 2 days later and Naruto told them to come with him to a grass field. And Sakura, Sasuke and Kakashi just went there. Oh, and Sakura was just super confused about what the hell happened to Naruto. So she didn't really tell anything to Naruto because she wanted an explanation as well. So Naruto walked and he saw a stone and went and sat there. And told the Jonin, Kakashi and the two Genin weirdos to sit. And they sat and Naruto then started to speak. "Well, you might be wondering what the hell has happened to me because of this whole markings and my eye having a different color and all, but I'll explain it to you." Sasuke has to explain. So, start. not a sad and says Sasuke, you're just in a hurry. Let me explain to you from the start about what the hell happened. Then Naruto took a few minutes of silence and then started. Well, do you guys know about the progenerate of chakra? Chakra is a progenerator of... what does that mean? Sasuke then commented, progenerator, you mean the god of shinobi? Naruto just nodded and Sasuke said, well, I don't know who it is. Then Kakashi said, Hagoromo. But what does it have to do with... Naruto interjected and said, listen, you guys just jump at all the causes, listen. And after hearing it, all the three teammates of Team 7 were shocked, because Naruto was the one who always jumped and he's telling them to stop, but they didn't really talk much of it and let Naruto continue. So the god of shinobi, the progenitor of chakra, Hagoromo Otsutsuki, once fought a big battle where he had to face a thing called the Ten Tails. And after defeating it, he had the choice to kill it. But then he found out that the Ten Tails was connected to the Earth's balance. And if he killed the Ten Tails, it would disrupt the balance of the Earth. And the worst possible outcome would be destroying the Earth. I mean, the Earth's destruction. So he decided to split the Ten Tails chakra into 9 forms. And before he could continue, Kakashi intercepted. 9 forms. Wait a second, you're talking about the 9 bijus? Naruto flinched for a second, then just nodded. Sasuke asked, bijus? What the hell are bijus? Then Sakura said, wait, why are you talking about this bijus kind of stuff? We just want to know what. Naruto doesn't raise his voice a bit. For God's sakes, let me finish. They, you know, quickly quickly shut up and Naruto continued. Well, as you heard, bijus are what you call tailed beasts. Okay, the one which attacked Konoha 12 years ago, the Kyuubi, is one of them. The 9 tails. It's called the 9 tails, and it is the strongest of the other of the 9 bijus. So then Sakura, but what does then Naruto the snapped? Can you shut up for a minute and let me talk? And then Sakura's like, yeah, I'm not gonna talk. Sasuke just rolled his eyes, because this is the third time that Naruto told us not to talk, but Sakura just couldn't understand it. Kakashi flinched for a minute because Naruto just raised his voice out of nowhere, but he understood because, well, they were annoying him with questions. So Naruto continued. As I said, the 9 tails which attacked Konoha 12 years ago is one of the 9 bijus. The 9 bijus are separated are in different countries on the world, and they are sealed within a person. That person is what we call a Jinchuriki. And I am the Jinchuriki of the 9 tails which attacked 12 years ago. This was a shock to both Sasuke and Sakura, but Kakashi, you know, took it well, because he was there at the time when this whole incident happened, so yeah. But Kakashi tried to put a shocking face, but Naruto just saw through it and he just glared at Kakashi, which made Kakashi did not want to act up. Then Sakura was like, but wait, what? Naruto just looked to Sakura, and yeah, Sakura just shut it up. And then Naruto continued, yeah, I am the 9 tail Jinchuriki, but I'm not the first one, I am the third one. The first one, well, I'll explain it a bit. So anyways, the nine bijus were not inside human at were not sealed inside the humans at first. They were just animals, you could say. They were living like animals, you know, in their own secret temple or something. But, well, shinobi were which are selfish. They wanted their powers, and so they tried to go after different beaches. And the Nine Tails was the only one who survived, lasted long enough without getting sealed, because he was the strongest of the all nine Bijus. Then Naruto took a deep breath and continued. But Madara Uchiha, well, he used the Sharingan to take control of the Nine Tails and fought against Hashirama Senju, because, well, what the QB told me was Madara was jealous of Hashirama because Hashirama was much more stronger than him, so he wanted to defeat Hashirama by any means possible, so he used the QB. But then Kakashi shouted, "You talk to the Nar, for once listen to me, please." Naruto just quickly intercepted, and Kakashi just shut up, because yeah, he wanted to listen to the entire story now. And Sasuke was the only one who wasn't interrupting, because he was hearing intently, because this included the Uchiha, the god of Uchihas, Madara Uchiha. So anyways, he continued. But after defeating Madara Uchiha, the Hokage Hashirama Senju got a plan to seal all the tail beasts inside a person, so they could be sent to different villages, so like a military power. But the Hokage didn't take into consideration of the Biju's feelings, because he thought they were just monsters used for battle, because Madara used the QB. But yeah, anyways, he sealed the QB inside his wife, Mito Uzumaki. When they heard this, you know, it wasn't a big shock for Kakashi, because Kakashi knew all of this because he was in the Anbu. This was a shock for Sasuke and Sakura. Then Naruto continued. And after she died, it was passed into another female, and he looked into Kakashi, and Kakashi instantly knew that Naruto knew who the second Nine Tails Jinchuriki was. He even guessed that he knew who his parents were. Naruto just shrugged it off, saying, "Well, I don't know." But Kakashi easily saw through the fake facade. Then Naruto continued. And some things happened which made the QB release from his Jinchuriki. And then came Madara Uchiha again, and when he said that, all three of them were shocked. But then Sakura asked, "Madara Uchiha, 12 years ago, how did Madara Uchiha come? How did Madara Uchiha came back? You should be dead." Naruto just saw her by inside, saying, "I don't know. Even the QB doesn't know. So let me continue." And he was controlled again and started to go rampant on the village. And that is the incident of the QB attack 12 years ago. Then Naruto was silenced and let them take all this big information, because it was big for Sakura and Sasuke, who thought that the QB just ran rampant because it wished to. And Naruto then continued. The fourth Hokage couldn't defeat the QB, so he stopped, and Sasuke asked. So Naruto just rolled his eyes and said, "He sealed it inside of me." Then Sakura asked, "Why?" Naruto just saw Kakashi again and just shrugged his shoulders, saying, "I don't know. Maybe I was an unlucky bunch." But anyways, the fourth Hokage divided the QB into a yin and yang half. He divided his chakra to yin and yang half and sealed the yang half inside of me and sealed the yin half inside of him before dying. He used a technique called the Reaper Death Seal. That technique used your soul as a bargaining chip to seal anything until it breaks through. Kind of, until if it doesn't resist. Then to start and let all of them take in the digestion, mostly Sakura and Sasuke. Then Sasuke asked, so you're saying that the reason why the village hates you is because... Yes, because I was made into a sacrifice to protect the village. Naruto said, sarcastically. But no one caught this. They were just so overwhelmed by the information they were given right now. But yeah, I didn't have a talk with the QB until now. And that comes to the question of which Kakashi asked. How the hell did I contact the QB? Well, Naruto just, dragged the well. And Kakashi asked, well, what? Naruto breathed in and breathed out. And he said, well, I got a heart attack by seeing Haku die. What? Naruto just shrugged his arms. Yeah, I couldn't control my heart beating so fast, so I got a heart attack. And that's why I used a jutsu which, took my soul and put it into some other's body. So, yeah. So what? So I'm immortal, kind of, I guess. Yo, what? Sasuke said. Then he just showed his movements for calming down. Sasuke, listen what I did. When I got the heart attack, the QB basically summoned me into his whole cage and put me on a genjutsu to show me what the hell the whole chakra network was going, the whole 10 tails, the story of him and Madara and Hashirama, that bullshit, and to use the jutsu called the Edo Tensei Impure World Reincarnation, in which you have to use your amount of chakra to basically resurrect a soul into a sacrifice. And I used Haku's body as a sacrifice to resurrect my gonna be dead soul into that, so I could get revived. And Sakura's confused. So use Haku's body as a sacrifice. And why did you, before Sakura could continue, Naruto said, because I had to maintain the balance of the earth. You wouldn't want to get destroyed, right? Sakura just shut up. Then Sasuke asked a question. Why did you use that whole chakra thing? Naruto just nodded and said, well, I didn't have the amount of chakra required to use the Edo Tensei, so I had to borrow, the 9th chakra. Well, yeah, after I had to use the Edo Tensei, and boom, here I am. So you used the Edo Tensei, but what does that cost in your body? Kakashi asked, and Naruto just said, well, it gives me a plus, I guess, in everything. I have an unlimited amount of chakra, I can live immortally, I am immortal now, and that's basically it, I guess. You have unlimited chakra? Yeah, Sasuke was that was his last straw. Naruto just nodded. You know what, I need you to teach me that jutsu, Sasuke asked. Naruto just raised his eyebrows and just said no. Sasuke asked, why? Naruto just says, because you don't have enough chakra, dumbass. And number two, why would you want to use that jutsu? Then Sasuke asked, to resurrect my clan. Naruto says, your clan isn't important for the balance of the nature, you dumbass. Then Sasuke was gonna retort, but he just stayed quiet because he was kind of angry right now because the whole thing happened. Then Sakura asked, wait a second. So you can bring other people back too, right? Naruto just saw her and nodded. Then since you said that you have unlimited chakra, so you could bring back the Uchiha clan? Then Sasuke just cheered up and looked at Naruto with forceful eyes. And Naruto got pressured by a little bit But Naruto just nodded. I mean, discarded and said, well, the Uchiha clan had almost 50 members. And then they had been dead for over more than 3 years. So I don't think I'll be able to bring them back. Now, then Sasuke has 3 years. What does that have to... Then Naruto cut in time limit. Can't do anything. Naruto just asked, but Kakashi knew that Naruto didn't want to bring back his family. I mean, Sasuke's family. Sasuke was just, you know, angry about him not getting his chance. But then Sakura's nothing. Now what are you gonna do? Naruto just saw her and shrugged his shoulders and said, well, I'm gonna try to live a normal life, I guess. I mean, I'm gonna live until the end of the world, so... And this jutsu allows me, cancels my reproduction system, so I can't even reproduce. Naruto and Sakura kind of blushed, but she quickly got... Excuse me, what? Kakashi asked him, said, Naruto just saw her and nodded, yes, I can't reproduce. Then Sasuke thought for a minute and asked something. Naruto, can you use the reincarnation jutsu on me? Then all of them turned into his and Sakura's to what? Why? He just told, well, because I want the unlimited chakra so I could kill my brother. Sasuke has it's an obvious question. Naruto pondered for a minute and he got up and said, well, it's not me to decide. Even though I have high amounts of chakra, I need to talk to someone. Talk to who? Kakashi asked. And he just, you know, took his shirt off. He didn't take his shirt off. He just pulled his shirt up and showed him the seal and said, this guy inside of me, I need to talk to him about it. Because he only showed me the hand seals for me using my own soul. I don't know how to use other soul just off yet. Then Sasuke asked, so it's possible? Naruto just nodded, but I won't consider it for now. I want you to live your life as for possible. Now Sasuke jumped up angry. I don't care about my life. I just want revenge against it. Then Naruto just said, as I said, live your life how you want. And then when you die, I'll consider reanimating you. Naruto, Sasuke was going to say something, but... Naruto did make a point, so yeah, Sasuke just sat down. Then Kakashi, you know, took a deep breath in and took a deep breath out and just said, well, can't do anything, so yeah, let's go back to the village. I think I need to tell this to the Hokage. When Kakashi said that, Naruto just, you know, breakneck chopped with this, you know, just looked at him with the speed. Even Sasuke just saw the speed, he thought that Naruto broke his neck. Naruto just said, no, hell no. Naruto said, wait, why? You are the third Hokage to tell me that the biggest asset, the biggest weapon in the Konoha village has died and has reincarnated so they could use me how they want? Naruto just asked me, they won't. He just stared at Kakashi and Kakashi couldn't continue. Exactly, even you know that there's one guy who could, who would, not could, would use me as a weapon. So yeah. Then Sakura asked, so if you don't want to tell the third Hokage, so how are you gonna the whole thing? Naruto just looked at himself and thought for a bit and then used the transformation jutsu and just transformed into his normal self and just said, just use the transformation jutsu, I guess. But then Sasuke said, well, how much time are you going? Oh, yeah, I forgot you have unlimited chakra. Naruto just said with a grin and said, well, let's go. And Naruto started walking off. Sasuke, Sakura and Kakashi just walked behind him. And that's where we're going to leave for this episode, guys. If you guys like this video, like, share, subscribe, do the necessary stuff. And if you don't, I can understand, so... Peace out. I'm gonna upload the next video whenever I get to upload the next video. Peace out.